वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं। Even as we set out to continue with our study of the Bhagavad Gita, I think it is worthwhile mentioning that this is all about discovering inner strength, discovering numerous sources of energy, wisdom, health, and whatever else you want, all inside. This morning here, 2 hours ago, I began and watched a little video where it is said that scientists have now discovered that nitrous oxide, if injected into the nostrils, can have lot of health benefits, and there is a hope that it can even kill some of these viruses like corona. And that video says certain pranayamas, certain simple pranayamas, and reciting Om every morning a few times causes certain vibrations in the certain parts of the nose, and that generates nitrous oxide. I tell you, I myself used to believe before that when the Upanishad said Atmana Vindate Viryam, I thought everything is from some deep inner Sat Chit and so on. No doubt that is the source, but that source Atma, Sat Chit, existence awareness, has actually empowered the mind and the body. The human mind, the human body have unbelievable capacities. The human mind, when it has the right outlook, can gain such tremendous strength. No problem remains difficult in that state of mind. And spirituality is about rising to that state of mind. Now, to complete this reference to the pranayama that releases nitrous oxide inside the nose, you don't have to buy that nitrous oxide spray from somewhere. We realize that there are millions of secrets about our own human body. And friends, let me not go long on it. It is high time that every one of us begins to live rightly. There are exercises, there are habits of eating, there are habits of sleeping, there are healthy habits of talking, there are healthy ways of living. Then you don't need any medicine, you don't need to go round about. You live wrongly, create problems, and then take different kinds of chemicals to solve those problems. What a terrible thing it is. Why not live intelligently, enjoy life, but living in healthy ways? Let solutions come from our own within. Our body handles any external attack. Our mind handles any external challenge of huge proportions. Now, That is what essentially Sri Krishna is telling Arjuna. You are confused and deluded, O Pandava prince. Just see the situation rightly and you will find that what appears to be a big dilemma, a big crisis, changes into a golden opportunity. We were at 39th verse, and that was a kind of summary shloka. Sri Krishna says all the spiritual disciplines belong to two categories. The higher level, call it A, that is Sankhya, which is Vedanta, which is Atmajnana, and the lower level is Yoga, which is Karma Yoga, which is Dharma, and so on. That was said in 39. Sankhye esha buddhihi tava abhihita. I gave you an understanding, referring to those first 15 verses. An understanding, buddhi here is understanding. In the domain of Sankhya, pure self-knowledge, we are the indestructible pure self. Now, yogetu imam shrinu. Let me tell you, in the domain of yoga, karma, dharma shastra, and having the right outlook in this domain of action, the healthy outlook, of course, being one of service, one of giving, one of not being selfish. Yogetu imam shrinu. Last sentence in Shankara Bhashya was, if one has this attitude, then Ishvara Prasada Nimitta Dana Praptya Eva Karma Bandham Prahasyasi. You will drop all entanglements, all agitations in your mind when you do Karma Yoga. At home, charity begins at home, they say, right? At home, in the society, at work, everywhere, let us go for Karma Yoga. We are here to serve. We are here to give our best to the other people in whatever context. Then Ishvara Prasada, that supreme truth called God, would bless us. Ishvara Prasada Nimitta, caused by the grace of God, there would be an astounding jnana. We'll have such an insight into life. Then where is any bondage? We will begin to smile, while a moment ago we were so desperate. Friends, in this 30th class now, over these YouTube sessions, in the 40th verse, Sri Krishna praises, in fact, both Sankhya and Yoga, but especially Yoga. Once we are inspired by the spirit of service, let others be unkind to us, let others be selfish, let others not thank us, let others be even harmful to us, we will not lose our goodness. We will remain good. We will remain loving, we will remain serving. In that kind of spirit, what is so special? Sri Krishna says in 40th, Shankara introduces Kincha Anyat, which it simply means, further, there is something more. Neha Bhikrama Nashosti Pratyavayona Vidyate Svalpamapyasya Dharmasya Trayate Mahato Bhayat. Simple Sanskrit. Atra, or Iha, Iha means Atra. Na Iha Abhikrama Nashaha Asti. Iha, here, as you and I begin to understand the beauty of living in selflessness, living in transparency, living in openness, all these come together. values are interrelated. Once we see the beauty of right living, then there is a fear. Well, sometimes we begin this a bit late. We may already be in our 60s, 70s, and we do a little, and then who knows, we may die. Will all this go a waste? Abhikrama means what you have begun, and that is prarambha. Abhikrama means prarambha. See the Shankara Bhashya. Abhikramaha prarambha, he says. Like a farmer works hard, tills the land, plows the land, sows seeds, and then, God forbid, but sometimes as it happens, no rains or some other calamity, natural calamity. So all the farmer's work of tilling the land and sowing the seeds, etc., goes a waste. Can such a thing happen in right living, in a life of service? Abhikramanashaha na asti. Prarambhanashaha, what we have started, will not go a waste. Pratyavayo na vidyate. Sometimes there is what is called pratyavaya. Pratyavaya is some adverse effect. We go for a treatment for a certain ailment, and instead of the ailment going away, imagine things get worse or a new problem begins. Pratyavaya. And Sri Krishna says here, there will be no adverse effect. What good you do will always be with you. And to emphasize that, Sri Krishna says in the second half of the shloka, Svalpamapi asya. Even if we have done just a little somewhere, Trayate mahato bhayat. It saves us, it protects us from huge dangers. Mahan or mahat bhayam. Mahat bhayam and mahato bhayat trayate. Therefore, in multiple ways, it makes sense to live rightly. Let's not live wrongly. Let's not go by false values, complicate our life, and then try to set it right. Why later on douse the fire? Why not prevent fire? Bhashyakara Sri Shankaracharya explains this. Na iha moksha marge. For that simple word iha, he gives neither Sankhya Yoga nor Karma Yoga. Yes, moksha marge. It's one path. Wherever you are, you get going from that point. You go further. But if you want to be very specific, the next word gives it. Moksha marge. And prastuta, the present context is karma yoga. Abhikrama nashaha na iha asti. Abhikrama may also be called abhikramanam, as Bhashyakara writes. And what is abhikrama? Whether you call it abhikrama or abhikramanam, prarambaha. Whatever we have begun, whatever we have invested. Sometimes, I think there was some great story in English literature, in the English classics, where a man receives a little help in some difficult circumstance from a young boy. And then that man goes away. Later on, that little young man, young boy, from nowhere, he doesn't know who is helping him, gets a lot of charity for his education, for his, you know, onward journey in life. And towards the end, if I remember right, the boy comes to know that all this money, all this support coming to me was from somebody whom I helped, not even intentionally, but it just so happened. I lent a hand of help. This little boy had, I guess, saved the life of that man, who was a foreigner, who had come from some distant town. But before leaving, he just notes down some details of this boy. Who are you? Whose son are you? What is this village? And then for rest of the boy's life, that millionaire who went away helps. So in life, that is of course very external. But karma yoga works in a lot of hidden internal ways. If we have even leave alone doing something, if we have listened to somebody's sorrow, somebody has to pour out, and you just listen patiently, oh, really sorry to hear that. Oh, I see. Then what happened? And how did you manage everything? You empathetically listen to somebody in sorrow. You go sit by the side of some patient, terminally ill or otherwise. You didn't do anything. You didn't even carry an apple or orange. You went empty-handed. Doesn't matter. In this world where nobody has time for anybody, you went to the hospital and he was not related to you, but you just thought, let me spend some time with some sick person. And you spent some time and genuinely you expressed concern. That is karma yoga. In fact, more you do without caring for what you get in return, deeper it is in terms of the form of karma yoga. Svalpamapi asya dharmasya mahato bhayat trayate protects tasya nashah nasti yatha krishyadehe. In krishi, agriculture, in farming, unless the whole process is over, you may incur terrible loss. You had taken great care for the early steps, but towards the end, as I said, there were no rains, or sometimes, God forbid, there were rains, there was nice sunshine, everything was, no locust or other insects coming and eating up, no pests, etc. The crop is up and shining and everybody is so happy. Wow, this time now we have to cut the crops and get these grains or whatever. Sometimes even there somebody may come, some jealous man, pour some petrol, some, and then set it on fire. Some revenge. Now all that goes a waste. In krishi, until you actually collect the grains, store them and begin to use, you can't say. But karma yoga is not like that. Karma yoga, every little you do, benefits, fruits are guaranteed. That is meant by abhikrama nashah na asti. Yoga vishaye prarambasya na anaikantika falatvam ityartha. Yoga vishaye, in this context of karma yoga, anaikantika falatvam na. See, double negative. If you remove the two negatives, ekantika falatvam bhavati. Na is one negative and anaikantika, an. So remove both. Ekantika phalam bhavati eva, anaikantika phalam na bhavati. Okay, what is ekantika phalam? Ekantika phalam is, you know, eka anta. For this cause, that is the result. One result. If you take this, such and such benefits will come to you. You take this tablet, your headache will go. You take that tablet, your stomach pain will go. Each one, let us say, has specific result. Ekantika, not going here and there. You know, you don't say, well, you do this, there are seven benefits and one of them will come to you. No, no, no. One-to-one mapping. That is called ekantika phala. And anaikantika phala is where you do something and one of seven, as I said, results may come. Such a thing is not the case with karma yoga. You do karma yoga, Chitta Shuddhi is guaranteed. Your mind becomes relaxed. Our mind is really, shall I say, a very funny thing. Sometimes, amidst a lot of problems, we find ourselves light-hearted, smiling away. Some other times, a tiny problem. We are trying to read Vedanta and suddenly our eyes fall on a cockroach in the room. We grab the book of Vedanta and we chase that cockroach and that somehow escapes and we lose all our... We were just studying Sthita Prajna or some high stuff. But a cockroach can make our life miserable and all of us know. Therefore, I want to give you the good news. The good news is, when you see that this mind is really not dependent on external things, it has tremendous flexibility inside. That is, even in the face of very mighty challenges, our mind has the capacity to remain cheerful. Find out how that can be your case. How we can be cheerful. In fact, great authors of modern times also have said that ultimately a successful life is one where a lady or a man learns to be happy, whatever. The art of happiness. If we learn to be happy, project completed, happy. Project not moving ahead at all, 30% over and not moving at all. Then also happy. You are happy every morning, you begin with happiness and new energy and do whatever is possible. By happiness, we don't mean laziness. If you are happy and we actually find ourselves again taking fresh stock of a situation and again exerting to do the best possible, that happiness and being ready to do the best possible itself is success in life. You are already a successful person. The external success is redundant. External success comes to you, good. If it doesn't come to you, who cares? That is the hidden truth. You lived your years in tremendous optimism, energy, cheerfulness, and you moved on. Others may say he didn't complete any project. That is their problem. You lived all your years happily. And somebody will complete it and hopefully they will give credit to you. You know, we have completed and we are celebrating the completion of this wonderful project. But at this moment, we must say that that guy or that woman, you know, did 90% but then passed away. Maybe they give credit to you, all that you had done. Or maybe they will forget you. If they give credit, good. If they forget, that is also their problem. You did, you lived enthusiastically. And let people put a label on you that you are a failure. That is their problem. Happiness doesn't depend on external success or failure. But happiness does depend on being happy. Be happy, whatever. Karma Yoga has that secret hidden in it. Because irrespective of the result of action, you are doing the perfect action, the best possible. I don't mean perfect by some external standards. Perfect meaning the best possible at your hands. Anekantika falatvam na bhavati ekantika falatvam eva asti atra karma yoga vishaye kincha na api chikitsavat pratyavayo vidyate bhavati. Pratyavayo, something going wrong. In fact, this word is elsewhere used when you don't do certain necessary karma. Like you have been asked to do Sandhya Vandana daily and you don't do. And you may wonder, by my not doing, which is an absence, how can some harm come to me, which is presence? By an absence, how can there be a presence? But it is said in the Shastras, don't argue. If you don't do what had to be done, there will be some harm. That's called pratyavaya. Either way, pratyavaya is something harmful. It is said, na pratyavayo vidyate. Like I had given earlier the example, somebody takes medicine, his ailment is not cured, that's one sad thing, and a new problem. He took medicine for stomachache continues as ever, but because of taking this medicine, he has severe headache. That is like extra, you know, one more harm. Na vidyate chikitsavat. Adi Shankara gives the example of chikitsa. All right. Almost all have rejoined. I see the holy number 18. 18 people have rejoined. So we were at this Solpamapyasya. This itself is a very nice motivational sentence. Solpamapyasya. Even if you do a little good, some of you know that there is a concept of acts, it's called random acts of kindness. Random acts. You don't have to have a big organization or you don't have to plan in detail. Just be in a spirit of service. An opportunity arises and you do an act of service. Random acts of service. And Bhagavan Krishna says, Svalpamapi dharmasya yogasya, for the context is karma yoga, not Patanjali's Raja Yoga, anushtitam, upon being practiced, trayate rakshati mahato bhayat. Here bhaya in a philosophical context is sansara bhaya, this worldly existence. As Bhashyakara again says, sansara bhaya is janma maranadi lakshanat. A simpler interpretation is various kinds of harmful effects. Side effect, yes. But in a deeper philosophical sense, it is punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. For life is marked by endless struggles and various forms of suffering. Sri Krishna continues. Bhashyakara connects the next shloka. Yeyam sankhye buddhihi. Ya iyam buddhihi sankhye. Yogecha. So whether it's on the higher level, atmajnana, or lower level, you have a sense of doership, but you have noble outlooks, that is yoga, vakshyamana, which is going to be said. A comment is in place. Vyavasayatmika buddhihi ekeha kuru nandana bahushakha hyanantascha buddhayo vyavasayinam. Lord Krishna uses a word, vyavasaya, in a sense that is generally less known. Vyavasaya here is nischaya. Vyavasaya here is clear and right determination. Clear and right determination. Earlier you had 100 false notions, and now you have one right understanding and you are firm in that. So to be firm with the right grasp of a situation is vyavasaya. And Bhagavan Krishna says, vyavasayatmika buddhihi eka iha. Eka is one only. Since buddhi is feminine grammatically, eka. If it were neuter, we would have said ekam. If it were masculine, we would have said ekaha. Vyavasayatmaka buddhihi eka iha kuru nandana. O descendant of the Kuru dynasty. Apparently, Though otherwise we call Dhritarashtra's children Kauravas, both Kauravas and Pandavas have come down from some Kuru, some ancestor apparently called Kuru. Therefore, Pandavas also can be called Kuru Nandana. But generally the word Kaurava is not used for Pandavas. Kuru Nandana is Arjuna only here. Bahushakaha hi anantaha cha buddhayaha. Understandings, so to say, avyavasayinam. Once we miss the right perspective, there may be 100 other perspectives. Some of them may carry a little good, but as long as we are not with the truth, suffering is unavoidable. The best example a commentator gave was in the well-known illustration of Advaita Vedanta of the rope and the snake. To know that to be rope is the truth. And once you think of possible false perceptions, somebody may mistake it to be a snake, somebody may mistake it to be a stick, somebody may think it is a fissure in the ground, somebody may think it's a discarded garland, somebody may think of it as a rubber tube. You may go on. Anantaha. False notions are infinite, but right understanding is one. Sri Krishna calls or makes an appeal to all of us to stay with the right understanding. Not blind faith in Shastras, but at the same time, a great receptive mind towards the Shastra can help us arrive in this. We must double check whether in the name of Shastra we have become some sort of fanatics, in the name of Shastra whether we have begun to violate some universal values. In that case, we need to recheck Shastra. Shastra would not have meant that. Our interpretation might have been gone wrong. So once there is a violation of universal value like Satya or Ahimsa or Samanata, universal brotherhood, equality towards all, and speaking truth, etc. These are universal values. If there is violation of universal values, so the understanding that is rope is one, and false understandings can be so many. Acharya Shankara says, Vyavasayatmika Nishchaya Swabhava Eka Eva Buddhihi. I was talking of universal values. So if somewhere we had going by the Shastra, at the same time we are very unfair to somebody at home or in the society, anywhere. We are telling lies or we are covering up the truth and say, no, the Shastra has said it. Hold on. Double check. So the Shastra needs to be understood. Shastra cannot advise us any immoral value at all. So, I just thought of commenting on how to arrive at this right understanding. Shastra is a great source, but we need to go about it carefully. Otherwise, in this world, a lot of fanatics in all the religions go by their scripture. Devil quoting the Bible, as the expression goes. So that right understanding, Bhashyakara says beautifully, Viparita Buddhi Shaka Bhedasya Badhika. Badhika means that which dismisses. When we come upon the right understanding, whether on the plane of Karma Yoga or Jnana Yoga, that right understanding very ably dismisses so many other false notions. Samyak Pramana Janitatvat. Because the right understanding is born, Janita, Samyak Pramana. it's born of the right means of knowledge. Like in the case of the rope and the snake, light, proper light is thrown and our eyes are all right. So with eyes functioning properly and there being light on that spot, we will see that it is a rope. Everywhere, samyak pramana, right means of knowledge and right setting for the pramana to operate. Your eyes may be all right, but if there is smoke at the spot where you are trying to see something, a smoke will prevent you, fog will prevent you from seeing the object as it is. Therefore, pramana, the means of knowledge, has to be right and it has to have the right setting. So, iha shreyo marge kuru nandana, on this path of the true good, shreyaha is true good. Yaha punaha, yaha is plural, a number of others which are itaraha, other forms of understanding, viparita buddhayaha, false ones. Viparita is contrary. The truth is that it's a rope, and contrary to it, one imagines it's a snake. So, viparita buddhayaha, yasam shakha beda pracharavashat anantaha aparaha anuparataha sansaraha nitya pratataha vistirno bhavati. You may put a comma there. Because of number of false notions being spread, people do propaganda of all that. Violence is propagated. Some lie is propagated by state machinery sometimes. Sometimes a huge government goes to great lengths to spread some lie within their own country and around the world also. They suppress truth. But why talk about international affairs? In personal life too, we come under some false influence, and for years and years in our life, we believe in something which is not the truth. But why did we do that? Prachara. There was some propaganda outside and inside, and we fell, we became a victim to it. Anantaha, endless, aparaha, having no limits, anuparataha, not coming to cessation, not coming to a close. This samsara, egoistic existence, goes on. Next part is, pramana janita viveka buddhi nimitta vashatcha uparatasu. By God's grace, thank God, we come across the right means of knowledge. Somebody shows to us, look, the statement that throws true light on this matter is this in the Shastra. Look at this. Somebody draws our attention to the right pramana. Then janita, from that right means of knowledge, there arises viveka buddhi, the true discrimination, and because of it, nimitta vashat, uparatasu, all those false notions subside. Uparama is withdrawing. Ananta beda buddhishu, those countless understandings which again and again made distinction. The truth is one Brahman and one alone is the truth. Bheda is false. Nanatva is false. Then samsaraha api uparamate. When those forms of false understanding subside, our egoistic existence also comes to a close. Taha buddhayaha bahushakaha. Bahushakaha is the word from the shloka. Having numerous branches. Bahuyaha shakaha yasam taha. That is the samasa explained. Ityetat, or rather, yes, ityetat. Pratishaka bedena hi anantascha buddhayaha. There are so many branches of philosophy. And you and I could become followers of some false school of philosophy. Philosophies which say there is no God at all. philosophies which say there is no Atma, philosophies that say really there is nothing right or wrong, do whatever you like. Philosophies which are steeped in ignorance, in selfishness, in some bigotry, some prejudice, some upmanship, philosophies which have vested interest. Therefore, pratishakha bhedena kesham avyasayinam. So, vyavasaya is clear determination in the intellect of what the truth is. Avyavasaya is where there is no such clear determination. Why does that happen? Acharya Shankara explains once more very patiently. Pramana janita viveka buddhi rahitana. Rahita means absent. Because in these people who are talking like that, there is no right understanding that would have arisen out of right pramana. They went by some other text, they went by some other work, they went by some other book. You read something somewhere and you get carried away by it. And in the light of it, you begin to aim all your guns against the true philosophy. Some atheism, some kind of negative thinking has very many times hijacked great minds in this world. Great people otherwise, alas, followed some false philosophy and they suffered and they caused suffering to humanity also. Thus, in these two shlokas, Lord Krishna makes a big case, a strong case for us to go by this yoga of selfless action and on the higher plane. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.